Welcome to another episode of Stems and Scales. My name is Jeremy Shechter, and I'm the Aquaponics Manager out here at Farm Tech in Dyersville, Iowa. Today we're going to be harvesting fish. The tank is about ready to harvest. We've got about 400 fish in there, each about a pound and a half to 2 pounds, so it's ready for them to come out. In order to harvest these fish, we need to empty the water in the tank to about a quarter of its full level so we can get in there and easily pull out all the fish. So to prepare for this, we've already shut off all the pumps to the system, and now what we're going to do is we're going to drain out all the water from the tank. And we don't want to drain that all to a drain, we want to save that water. So we've got Gabe Smoots here, he's our greenhouse specialist. He's got a sump pump that we're going to put in the tank, and we're just going to run a line from the tank into our drainage lines. In order to be able to do this, we've actually lowered the water level in the rafts, so we've just turned off our float valves in the rafts so that there's extra capacity for this extra 1,200 gallons from this tank to be stored there. The pump that we're using to drain this tank is a simple submersible pump that you would use in any kind of sump, and it'll take about an hour to pump the 1,000 or so gallons that we're getting out of here. So in about an hour, we'll come back and we'll harvest the fish. When you're harvesting tilapia, it's really important to purge the fish before you sell them. So what purge means is you just don't feed them for 3 to 5 days, and you also want them in nice clean water. So the standard for purging is to actually take all of your fish out, put them in a separate tank for about 3 to 5 days, nice, clean, clear running water, and that purges all that off taste from the fish. But here we've actually experimented with a slightly simpler purge, where instead of taking them out of the system and putting them in clean water and purging them that way, we just don't feed them for 5 days, and what we've found, just not feeding them for 5 days is enough to eliminate that off taste. So you can see here, the feed per day and amount per feeding, it just says purge. That's because we haven't fed them since Monday. Today's Friday. So now that most of the water's gone, we're gonna actually start harvesting the fish right out of this tank. Now, there's a couple of different ways that you can harvest the fish. For really, really big productions, they've got these huge fish pumps that take it all out for you. In bigger tanks, they also have really big seine nets to kind of corral the fish in one area so some people can grab some nets and fish them out. But we found for these 1,200 gallon tanks, the best thing to do is really get yourself a nice pair of waders, hop in the tank, and net them out. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a net, gonna harvest some fish out, hand the net to Gabe, our greenhouse specialist, outside of the tank, and then he's gonna hand me a fresh net, and we're just gonna go back and forth. So what we're harvesting these fish into, though, is a big tank full of water and ice. So that's the way that we dispatch our fish, is by throwing them into an ice bath. Since tilapia are warm water fish, cooling them down really rapidly in 35 to 40 degree water is a great way to dispatch them quickly. Becca? And now that all the fish are harvested from this tank, what we're gonna do is we're gonna wait for all of them to stop moving on the ice, and then we're gonna individually package them in bags and store them on ice. When you're storing fish, it's really important that you have them in a cooler and they're always covered in ice. So here's the very last fish from our fish harvest. So aquaponics really is like fishing in a bucket.